Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Father.
Let us call to mind our sins as we seek the Lord's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh, the splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, to be our mother also. Grant, we pray, that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exalting in the holiness of her children, may draw to her embrace all the families of the people. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Jesus had been taken up to heaven. The apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women, and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glorious things are told of you, O City of God.
Glorious things are told of you, O City of God.
His foundation upon the holy mountains, the Lord loves. The gates of Zion, more than any dwelling of Jacob.
Glorious things are told of you, O City of God.
Glorious things are told of you, O City of God. And of Zion they shall say, one and all were born in her, and he who has established her is the Most High Lord.
Glorious things are told of you, O City of God.
They shall note when the peoples are enrolled, this man was born there, and all shall sing in their festive dance, my home is within you.
Glorious things are told of you, O City of God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." From that hour, the disciple took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine, so they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it up to his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he handed over the spirit. Now, since it was preparation day, in order that the bodies could not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for the Sabbath day of that week was a solemn one, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and they be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and then of the other one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately, blood and water flowed out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Jean Vanier was the founder of L'Arche, the international network of communities for people with intellectual disabilities. And Vanier died recently last month at the age of 90. But he wrote a book entitled Jesus, the Gift of Love. And he writes about Jesus' vision of church. Jesus had called them together to form community with him and around him and with many other disciples, men and women, a bonding deeper than family ties. Community where they learned to care for each other, where each had his or her place and gift to exercise, where they learned also about brokenness, jealousy, their desire for power, and their need for forgiveness and healing, their need also to forgive, where they learned continually to be open to the poor, the lame, the broken, and the blind. Not a closed community for security, but a community for healing and for helping each other to grow in freedom and in love. A community of mutual support which announced the good news by its existence and from which some could go out to announce the good news of God's love. Jesus loved these men and women who had left all to be with him. Those who follow Jesus and give up all for him will receive from Jesus. So this vision of church that Vanier so beautifully articulates illuminates our own parish community as well. And Mary, the mother of Jesus, is the perfect image of the faithful disciples whose generosity of heart and spirit realizes his vision of the church. Last year, Pope Francis instituted today's memorial of Mary under the title of Mother of the Church, and it's to be celebrated on the day after Pentecost, the end of the Easter season. The title is the title doesn't belong from Francis. It originally came from Pope Paul VI, as he closed the third session of Vatican II in November of 1964. And the title, Mother of the Church, was the speech that he delivered to all the bishops of the world that gathered for that session. Mary was not only Jesus' mother, she was also his first disciple. And with a mother's love, she was a presence of wisdom and peace in the midst of her son's followers. From the moment she walked away from the cross on Good Friday to the dawning of Pentecost. And so may we see in Mary the model of what it means to follow Jesus with humility, joy, and selflessness. In Mary's example, May we become the church of mercy and peace envisioned by her Son. Trusting in the eternal goodness of God, we bring to Him our needs and concerns. For an increase in religious vocations in the Church, may God bless those who are discerning with open ears and generous hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations and communities, may the graciousness of our God encourage their own faithful stewardship of the earth and its resources. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the homeless and those struggling to keep their housing, may the God of all compassion provide for their many needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers and fathers, may they be strengthened by the Spirit as they strive to raise holy children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially those known only to God, may they rest in eternal peace with the risen Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray especially at this Mass for the Fox family, and for what or for whom do we pray for today?
For a safe voyage for the Roman Catholic Right Peace Squadron and all of us from offshore industry. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those that have received our blessed prayer shawls, may they be comforted.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all patients who are undergoing surgery today, for them let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, you will that your children be reconciled to you through your Son. We ask that you hear these prayers, which we make in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer you, fruit of the earth, and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept us and our sacrifice in your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Church.
Receive our offerings, O Lord, and transform them into the mystery of salvation, so that by its power we may be set aflame with the charity of the Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church. and with her may be united more closely to the work of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to proclaim your greatness with due praise as we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary. Receiving your word in her immaculate heart, she was found worthy to conceive him in her virgin's womb, and giving birth to the Creator, she nurtured the beginnings of the Church. Standing beside the cross, she received the testament of divine love and took to herself as sons and daughters all those who, by the death of Christ, are born to heavenly life. As the apostles awaited the Spirit you had promised, she joined her supplication to the prayers of the disciples, and so became the pattern of the Church at prayer. Raised to the glory of heaven, she accompanies your pilgrim church with a mother's love, and watches in kindness over the church's homeward steps, until the Lord's day shall come in glorious splendor. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you forever. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth, holy Lord,
Hosanna.
Lord, you are indeed holy, you are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, your people spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Pray the words that Jesus himself once prayed. Our Father, who art in heaven. blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith and courage of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Christ. heavenly help, your church may teach all nations by proclaiming the gospel, and through the grace of the outpouring of the Spirit, fill the whole earth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.